guys, and welcome to the final episode of Demon of Chromatic 2. It ends. This level is the final boss encounter of the game. You get stuck to pretty much everything except the BFG, but like I said, there's no BFG in this mode. And it's a good thing, you can play this level from scratch if you want to play just the encounter again. Like in the first Demon of Chromatic. Alright, so let's see who our boss is. It is the Icon of Sin again. But it will be different this time. We get two save scrolls on the side if you want to get them in the middle of the fight or between waves. So let's just get started. So this fight a little like the first encounter fight in the second map. You have to defeat all the Ashrites to progress. As long as Ashra is alive, they will spawn new waves that are increasing power. First we get Kekkos and Shotgunners, which is kind of the more annoying wave, just because of the Kekkos in a big open area. You really want to kill all the Shotgunners first, because they are much more dangerous than Kekkos. Because there are not going to be any dangerous there, but they are going to be a pain in the ass to kill. I would have been done with this wave if there was something other than Kekkos. This is pretty much my only complaint about this fight. The start is tedious. And here I made a pretty big mistake. Should have killed that guy to the right and now there's both guys on both sides, which is very bad. This wave now has already Arachnos runs in it. The escalation is pretty fast. So you have to make this fight as short as possible. You want to use your rockets on the enemies and give the plasma for the Archrise and for what's coming next too, but you really need this plasma ammo for the Archrise. There's plenty around, but yeah, that gets off when you use it pretty fast, so watch out for this. I like this kind of escalating fight that keeps the pressure on you, and you really have to hurry up and make it finish. I wish though that the waves were timed or they would start when there's only a few guys left. Because finishing all these guys can be a little annoying, like against the Kekko Demons. And making sure I have range over this altar to the right. But that won't be enough. I won't be able to kill the one to the left. Because of the guys in my way. Yeah, Arthur and nice now. It's getting more and more deadly. Using more and more ammo to defeat these guys because obviously they have more health and yeah. This is a good fight though. They are pretty nice. You have plenty of ammo and health and stuff to go around. You can use this auto slow spray to save if you want. You don't even have to quick save yourself. Don't use this cross when you're on your fire though, because do that, you might have a very bad save spot where you save you load the game and dive to enemy fire. You don't have too much stuff though, like health and armor is limited. Ammo isn't really much though. I don't manage to kill the last archer in time because of my bad luck, but I do fine. And this way is kind of one of the most deadly. Escan enemies and Revenants. the worst thing that could happen to you. The one next to this one, I think it's Revenant and Hell Knight. Which is not as bad because they will in fight and block each other's shots. But here, just the Iskam guy that's tough on you and the Revenants that may finish you. Revenants are really bad there. You don't have much cover at all. There's the pillars, but it's not very good. You can't spend time hiding behind them because this guy's all over the place. So you have to really walk around and try not getting blown up by the big pile of rockets following you. Which can be tricky. You really want to end this at this point because you can't stand Revenant for too much time. If you're good at dodging, yeah, but you definitely take some hits. Chase wave. Alright, now for phase 2. The Iconocene summons bosses in the center and imps will continue to appear everywhere. Again, you have to make haste and kill the bosses first. Because, like, every 10 seconds, there's 15... Yeah, I think 15 imps spawning. It's not too bad, but... Yeah, you'll get out of ammo eventually if you try to kill them. They'll block your shots. Cyber Demon is kinda hard to hit at this point because he can move and dodge your shots, but that's fine. Second thing, Spider Mastermind. You have really no cover for this guy, just nothing. So you need to keep shooting at him. You might want to take cover behind the imps, but you need to take him down fast. And down he goes. All the imps are reduced to gibbs. And that's it. You've won. Pretty nice fight, not too long. Pretty fun. Kill some stuff. And so I can see staying there. Just waiting for us to come say hello to it. First though, we have to find that secret this level has. So let's check out what's behind this wall altar thing. I don't know if there's any other way to get to there without a rocket jump, but if you have still enough health, you can get to it pretty easily. Ha! Nice! I guess we kicked it. Somehow we kicked his ass. This place is also... I mean, it's kinda well done because you can't really see the borders of the map, unlike most classic maps, where there's clear borders and always walls at the end, like, you know, in M1, M8, for instance. It's good to see an endless sea of lava. It's... really feels like you're in hell. Grabbing stuff for no reason. Now we'll leave you with the good ending. I hope you enjoyed these videos, and I will see you later.